Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how to create realistic sphere lighting together. I want to show you two examples. One of these examples, the one you see here, is the one I will make together with you. And this is an example that I often see in some renders, which I think kills the realism. We will be making the one on the right together. Small details like these are very important for taking your renders to a more realistic level. Let's get started right away. Now, I will quickly take an interactive render. Let's shrink our screen a bit. As you can see, it's a dim environment. With this lighting, I will try to illuminate this environment. First, let's assign a material to this together. This material needs to be just slightly translucent. So I'm applying this material onto the globe. After assigning it, I'll add a bit of glossiness. I can set its roughness to 0.2. As you can see here, I'll get a nice shine. By marking thin shell, I'll achieve translucency using the translucency setting. I'll set this to 0.5. It's translucent. So let's test this out. Light inside. I'll use corona light for this. I'll place a sphere inside like this. I'm moving the light upwards as well. Now, of course, we can increase its diameter a bit. After placing this lighting, let's take a look at the light settings. The values you see here might all be enabled on your end. But generally, in this kind of work, we prefer to disable all the features, mainly to positively affect our render times. Now, here it's emitting light outward. Now, let's focus a bit on its material. Look, this image isn't bad, and yes, it looks like there's a light, but it's not actually emitting light outward. I'm going to improve its material a bit. For this, we're using falloff. I'm going to connect falloff to the base color. Then I swap the positions of black and white. Look, the outside has become black, and the inside, the areas you see here, have become whiter. Here I'm going to add bezier. Look, you can follow along here to see what the operation I'm doing corresponds to. So my goal is this. I can see that I want to create a black shadow on the outside. Now, I'm also going to connect this falloff to the translucency. This is an important detail as well. This way, the inner part will receive more light because the inside is white. Of course, if you want, you can shift the black value here a bit more towards brown. But in my scenario, this is perfectly sufficient. Now, this lighting illuminates an environment, but it doesn't emit light outward. So how are we going to do that? If we try to light up this environment using only the light inside, we'll end up with light blowouts in the resulting image. To avoid this, we're going to add a little detail. I'll try to explain this to you in my own style. Now, I'm selecting the lighting itself. Let's also stop our render. I'm going to leave this alone on the screen. So I'm coming over to Edit Poly. I pressed F4 on my keyboard. If you double click on any line here to split it, the program will cut the line exactly at that point, creating two separate segments from where you clicked. Because as an element, I only want to select this outer part. After selecting this outer part, I use Shift and Control to scale it up a bit, and I call it fake light. So what did I actually do? There are two elements here, one sphere on the outside and one sphere on the inside. By scaling this up, I basically made a copy of it. Now we're going to prepare a material for this as well. We will define a corona light material. I'll also set the color of the corona light material using corona color. I'm connecting the corona color to the color input. From here, I'll enter any Kelvin value I want. We determine the warmth of the light with Kelvin. Now, after coming here, for example, I set the intensity value to 7. Yes, that's quite good. It's emitting light outside. In fact, let me assign this to the new material I just copied. I'll select Unhide All. Let's see what's happening while we render at the same time. The example outside is similar to the first example shown. I want to set it to visible, visible in reflections and visible in refractions. Doing this, you can see it emits light around, but it doesn't light up the floor well. That's why I'm going to enable visible in reflections. Thanks to visible in refractions, look, I was able to cast light downward. A very realistic visual has started to form here. Look, there are tiny points where the light is cut off here. In other words, since the model here and this part are overlapping, most likely there's a tiny break happening here. Let's go ahead and try to fix that as well. Here, my model is selected. I'm zooming in on my model. Here, I select two polygons and let's set the soft selection to 10 centimeters. I move them slightly inward like this. This way, I minimize the cutting operation here. Likewise, you can do the same thing here. I'm taking it in just a tiny bit like this. What we need to pay attention to here is that this shouldn't go directly inside the visual. In other words, inside the model. You can also do the same for the ones in the back if you want to render from different angles. So let's play around a bit with the material and the light inside. We give yellow light by making the material more yellow. In fact, let me pick a color from here.
Right.
Making it more yellow lets us color globe itself and make this closer brown. It could be a dark brown. To make it as realistic as possible, and we can also increase the light inside a bit. From here, I select light from the selection tools. I pressed F3. You can either increase the radius of the lighting inside, or you can increase its intensity. Yes, as you can see, in these kinds of applications, if you create a lighting system the way I did, you can achieve truly realistic and beautiful results. Thank you for watching. See you in another video.
Just